What is up, guys? Rick Kakis here, and this is Wrath of the Machine for Dummies, the complete raid guide showcasing every single tip, trick, and mechanic I know for every single encounter in the new Wrath of the Machine raid added into Destiny with the Rise of Iron expansion. Now, of course, making an entire raid guide is a lot of work. If you guys find this video helpful, please remember to return the favor and simply rate and especially share this video, even if it's just telling a friend. Additionally, for your convenience, there is a menu in the description down below with every single encounter timestamped. So whenever you want, you can come back to this video and find the exact part you're looking for. Now without further ado, let's get started. Now actually, a very useful tip before you even start this raid is go to Fellwinter's Peak and talk to Shiro 4. He's actually going to have a new quest that has you kill the different bosses in this raid in order to complete it. Now I actually totally forgot about this, so don't make the same mistake I did. When you begin the Wrath of the Machine raid, the first thing you're going to do is enter into an open area kind of somewhat similar to when you started the King's Fall raid. There's going to be an event you have to do here, although the respawn timer will be fairly open with only a 5 seconds respawn timer instead of the normal 30. What this encounter has you do is charge up 3 different devices. There's one located almost immediately when you first spawn in, right out in the open, and then there's 2 more on each side. All of these look identical, so if you find the first one in the middle, look for the same thing on the right and left side. All of these devices will have white objective circles around them. Now you're then going to notice very quickly that you have to deal with a boss. This boss is killed with the use of these objects, to which I will now explain. Essentially, what you need to do is power up these objects. That is done by going around to the glowing objects that you can see scattered all around the map. You're going to see me running through them all the time in the background gameplay, but again, they're kind of glowing pillars of light. If you run through them, you will become charged. Now, if you run through one of these objects, you become charged, and you wait the 15 seconds and the charge runs out, you will die. What you actually need to do is run through 3 more of these charges. If you run through 4 charges, it will create max voltage, and you will actually see in the bottom of your screen where the timer is, it will say that you have achieved maximum voltage. Once you have reached maximum voltage, head over to one of the objectives, those devices with the white circles around them, and once you're within that white circle, you can hold square on the PlayStation, X on the Xbox, and you're going to slam, the exact same thing that you have to hold, if you remember, to the Deathslingers. You'll slam those objectives, you'll slam those devices, and you will power them up. And you can actually see they will have a small monitor on the front of them that will actually have a circle that will fill up until it's fully charged. So all you need to do, since there's 3 objectives, is to assign your team of 6, 2, 2, and 2, 2 to each one of these devices. Then get one of them to simply stay at the devices, kill all of the adds. Make sure to kill the energy eater shanks because they will actually drain those devices of their much needed energy. So again, split up your team so that 2 people cover each one of these devices, have one person stay there and kill adds, and the other person run around and collect the charges, and come back and of course slam and power the devices. Once you do this enough time, you have slammed the device enough times, it will actually turn on and start producing these SIVA bombs. These SIVA bombs will be a common occurrence throughout this raid. Now you can actually pick up the SIVA bombs, either player can do this, and just chuck them at the boss. Throwing a bunch of these bombs at the boss will lower his shields, and once the shields are down, you can start damaging him with your normal weapons, like of course, the Galahorn. By the way, I went through the entire raid with a Galahorn and it seemed to be fantastic. It's definitely one of the weapons I would recommend for being good in this encounter. Now once you've done a bunch of damage on that boss, his shields will recharge and you simply need to do the same thing over again. Charge up the devices until they produce more bombs, throw the bombs, lower his shields, and then damage him as much as you can. Do this a few times and you'll damage the boss enough that he will actually retreat into the raid and the giant glowing sphincter will open and let you in to the rest of the Wrath of the Machine. Upon heading into this opening, you will find a chest pretty much immediately to your left. Check it out, because I actually got an exotic from this, so this actually is this raid's exotic chest, or at least one of them. As you head into the depths of this raid, you will encounter a fairly straightforward jumping puzzle. There's basically only one way you can go, you just need to figure out what to jump on, and all of the jumps are fairly obvious. However, once you actually get to the end location, as you can see here, instead of continuing on, if you continue with the direction that this corridor heads in, you will actually find a SIVA cluster. Head all the way to the very upper back left corner of this giant rectangular corridor, and you will find the SIVA cluster. Moving on, once you've navigated through that section, you will encounter your first real boss fight, although it is against the boss that you already tried to kill. This time, you'll do it for real. Now, there is a lot of mechanics in this encounter, so getting used to them and knowing what happens when is the most important factor in your success. The room you're going to be in when you engage this boss is naturally going to kind of split into three sides, a middle, a right, and a left side. Again, split up your team 2, 2, and 2. After fighting adds for only a few seconds, there will be those SIVA bombs that drop from the ceiling. Upon doing so, one of those teammates, so one person from each of the squads of two, splits off and grabs those SIVA bombs. At this point, you throw them at the boss himself. Now, this is very important. A lot of people are going to have trouble with this section if they don't know about this. Throwing the bombs kind of willy-nilly will not lead to success, simply because these bombs will do a lot of damage or not very much damage. Essentially, the first bomb actually takes away his barrier. You'll see a glowing red barrier around him. The other two bombs actually do the majority of the damage to his shields, which don't regenerate. You're gonna have to get his shields down in order to damage him. So make sure that you communicate with your team and say, okay, throwing the bombs in 3, 2, 1, try to throw them all at relatively the same time. If you throw one bomb and then wait a few seconds and throw another one, the barrier will actually regenerate, and then you'll have two bombs that do very little damage. So again, you need to communicate and throw those bombs at relatively the same time. After only about 5 or 10 seconds after hitting the boss with all three bombs, you're going to have another mechanic that you're really going to have to keep on top of. Now, you can see behind the boss there is a bunch of different monitors. Now, one of these monitors will actually start to glow. It will come on, as you can see here. When this happens, shoot that monitor as quickly as possible in order to disable it. Disabling it doesn't actually take that much damage. You can just have a few people with primaries take it down relatively quickly, but you do definitely need to be on top of this, because if you don't shoot that monitor, or if you shoot the wrong monitor, so make sure you're not using an area of effect damaging attack, make sure you're not using a rocket launcher to do this, because again, if you damage the wrong monitor or you don't disable this monitor quickly enough, there will be something that pops up on the bottom left side of your screen saying SIVA density critical. If this happens, it has the power to wipe your team. What you need to do to survive this if things go wrong is to look on the doors. There'll be two doors, two separate rooms on the right and left side. Look at these doors when the SIVA density is getting critical, and you'll see one of them is glowing. Everyone needs to run in here as quickly as possible and shoot the device on the side of the door, as you can see here, and the door will close and save you from that devastating attack. Anyone left outside will be instantly killed. However, if everything is going right, you're throwing the bombs and then you're shooting the right monitor, you won't have to do that mechanic for a long time. In fact, you'll have to do that same thing. Throw the bombs, shoot the monitor, enemies are going to respawn, you do the exact same thing, kill enemies for a bit, grab the bombs, throw them, look for the monitor, shoot the monitor, you're gonna rinse and repeat that a few times. Importantly, there will be one of the raves that actually spawn a yellow health splicer captain, so make sure you have, you know, supers or heavies to deal with this guy. Trying to ignore him is not a good idea, there'll be one on each side. But once you've done enough rounds of this and thrown the bombs enough times, you will lower his shields completely. At that point, again, you need to DPS him, damage per second him, as much as possible. Do as much damage in a short of period of time as you absolutely can. So Galahorn is great for this, snipe rifles are fantastic, and damage increasing supers like tethers and weapons of light in a bubble are also great. However, when you damage him and he gets his shields back, you will see that Siva density increases text appear at the bottom of your screen, which means that you will need to run inside one of those doors, shoot the device that closes the door, save the majority of your team. If a couple of people die, it's not a big deal. You'd rather have a couple of people get left outside than your entire team wait too long to close the door, so keep that in mind. But once you do that, once that door closes and the Siva, you know, blast goes through the room and leaves you alive, you'll just have to go and rinse and repeat. Throw the bombs again, you'll have to lower his shields again. Once his shields are down, you will be able to just DPS him and this time hopefully kill him. Once you kill him, he is going to drop some sweet raid loot, hopefully. But not only is he going to drop loot, but there's also going to be a raid chest that actually spawns. This chest is actually opened by using a certain key. You actually got this key at the end of beating the normal Rise of Iron campaign. It's called a Siva cash key. You can use it on any one of these chests that require a key in this raid, and once you use it, it will be gone forever. However, you can actually go into your inventory, look at your Siva key fragments that you get throughout this raid, and you can convert those to a key, as you can see here, to open more chests. After killing this boss, you head deeper into the raid, faced with another jumping puzzle, kind of similar, in fact very similar, to the first one you faced, where you're making your way through a long open corridor, and you just have to kind of know where to jump. Again, the jumps in this raid are fairly simple. King's Fall is way tougher in my opinion. However, you're not going to continue through this part just yet because we have a secret chest to go to. Head to exactly where you're seeing me go. It's kind of an upper room when you're going through this corridor. Continue in this upper room and follow the hallways until you get to this area with four cylindrical pillars. Nestled in between two of these pillars on the left is a hidden chest. Moving on, after you've continued through that section, you're going to finally arrive on the top of the Cosmodrome wall and verse the Death Zamboni that we all saw from the trailers. Now, the very first thing you're going to notice in this encounter is that a lot of enemies are going to spawn right in front of you. You need to kill these splicer dregs as quickly as possible. So, huge area of effect damage dealing supers like hammers, like Stormcaller Warlocks are going to be fantastic for this part. Because if you don't take care of these adds, they will take care of you. There is a lot of them. The best thing to do is, again, have a few of your teammates, like the Hammer Titans like myself, pop their hammers and actually deal with these adds, and have the other teammates DPS the boss. Now, what you're going to need to do to the boss is that at the very front of this boss, at kind of the, you know, head section of the Death Zamboni, there's going to be a turret on the right and left side. Shoot these two turrets one at a time, and once you kill those two turrets, the middle section of this head is going to open up, exposing a glowing orange center. You then shoot the glowing orange center, and it's actually going to make a hull breach in the giant vehicle. Once the hull breach is created, once you see that text appear that there is a hull breach, you then actually run at it, hop on, and then just take it for a ride. Be careful to go to the very top, it will hurt you when it smashes through the next section of the Cosmodrome wall. Once it smashes through this section and you can see the next part of the Cosmodrome wall, your team is going to have to hop off of the Zamboni and continue on with this encounter. Move your team to the new section of the wall where the splicer ship is hovering. You're going to need to kill a yellow bar splicer captain, and then once you do so, it's going to drop some parts from this ship. Your mission is to bring those parts back to the Death Zamboni and install them in the right places. However, picking up each of these three parts is going to slow you down substantially. As soon as you pick it up, you can see that you're encumbered, and you're actually only going to have 10 seconds to move forward with this part. Once that 10 seconds is up, you're then going to be exhausted, and you're going to have to wait another few seconds before you can pick up a part again. So the best thing you can do is to switch off 3 and 3 with your team. Three people carry the devices at first, the other three just worry about adds. Once the first three can no longer carry those parts, then the other three hop in and switch with them. When you're exhausted, you can still fly around, jump around, kill enemies, all of that stuff, it's just that you can't pick up a part again. Now the three people killing adds are really gonna have to have their shit together. Make sure you're using offensive supers, hammers, golden guns, again, Stormcaller Warlock, Nova Bomb, all of that stuff, because you're gonna need to be Galahorning and using your supers on those splicer captains every time you see them. If you don't, they can easily wipe your team. So make your way with these parts back to the vehicle. Once you bring the parts close enough to the vehicle, it will actually shut down. You'll no longer have the ramp on the front of the vehicle to go up on. So what you need to do is to get your team to hop onto this vehicle and kill the adds immediately in front of you. You then have to shoot the giant glowing object behind the very front of the vehicle, as you can see me shooting right now. Once you do enough damage to this section of the vehicle, and you can actually again see a monitor with a circle fill up to show you how much damage you actually have, once it's all the way filled up, there's going to be another enemy, a yellow health splicer engineer, on top of this vehicle. Head up to the top and kill him. If you do enough damage to this glowing section of the vehicle and kill the engineer, it's then going to open up the front part of the vehicle, allowing you to carry those parts on. At this point, I'm sure a lot of you have noticed that your screen is starting to get some sort of effect on it. That's because there is a time period to this encounter. If you don't do this stuff fast enough, your entire team will just die, so you need to be on top of everything. And one of the most important factors is knowing where to install all of these parts. Firstly, you're going to have a part called the drive shaft. You're going to have to install this in the very immediate part where you just enter onto this vehicle after getting up the ramp and to the right. Next, you're going to have the warhead. This is installed on the very middle of the machine on the right-hand side, coming onto it. And lastly, the engine is installed in the very back left-hand corner of the machine, you know, if you're looking at it face on, where the truck is. Install all of these parts fast enough, and you will actually destroy, I don't know how installing parts is actually going to destroy it, but in any event, you will destroy this vehicle. Once you do that, you need to make sure to jump off the back quickly, or else you'll fall down into the abyss with it. Speaking of falling into the abyss, once it falls off the end, you're then free to jump down to the platform that you can see below, and there will be another chest. This is also the location of another SIVA cluster. Once you jump down to this platform, head to the right of the platform, as you can see, drop down to another kind of section sticking out, and there'll be a cave with, again, that new SIVA cluster. Moving on, you actually just get to continue now through the raid and explore a huge section of it, and some really cool looking sections as well. There's no really hard encounters in this part, just travel through the raid until you get to the final encounter. You are going to find this big server room, but you basically just need to head to the back right-hand corner to continue on your way. And I've gotta say, holy crap, does this raid look cool. And after making your way through, you're going to drop down to the final boss encounter. There is a section that you have to beat first before the actual final boss fight, but both sections will take place in this location. And oh man, do these encounters have a lot of mechanics to them, but I'm gonna do my best to explain it to you guys. Now, yet again, you're going to split up your team 2, 2, and 2, with 2 in the middle, 2 on the right side, and 2 on the left side. The boss in the middle is going to shoot at you, so make sure you're not standing out in the open. Use the pillars for natural cover. Now, after killing Ads for just a while, a yellow health Splicer Reaver Vandal is going to spawn. Once you kill this enemy, it is going to trigger the captains to spawn. Now the captains will spawn from these doors as you're seeing here. There's an identical one on the left side and there's one in the center on the left hand side of the center section. Now these are the same doors that the servitors, which are going to be very important in a bit, spawn out of as well. So take a few seconds to actually look and make sure your entire group is familiar with these doors and where these enemies are spawning. However, once your captains spawn, you need to kill them as quickly as possible. So use Galahorn, and actually shotguns are pretty fantastic for this part. You won't need a sniper in this particular section. There's no boss you need to DPS, so shotguns being able to kill those captains pretty quickly are something that I would recommend. Once you kill those captains, they're going to drop Scorch Cannons. However, only one will be a Scorch Cannon. You're also going to get a Null or a Void Cannon and a Shock Cannon. So you're going to get a different cannon of each different element. Have one person from each of the teams of two pick those cannons up because they're very important. Now, out of those same doors, basically right after you're done killing your captains, a servitor will spawn. Very importantly, it's going to be a different elemental servitor depending on the different element of the captain you killed. Now, what I'm saying is this. If a shock captain comes out of your door and you kill that shock captain and you pick up his shock cannon, everything's seeming good in the world of shock. However, the servitor that comes through that same door will not be shock. It will be void or scorch every time. So what that means is the person with the elemental cannon needs to communicate with the team and you guys need to call out where the servitors are spawning. So call out, you know, shock servitor, right side, void servitor, middle, and scorch servitor, left side, or whatever the spawns actually are. It's random every time. Once you've called out which elemental servitors are where, the people with the shock cannons go to kill them. Now, to kill an elemental servitor, again, you have to remember to shoot it with the right type of scorch cannon. If you have a shock cannon, you have to shoot the shock servitor. If you shoot the void one, it's not gonna do anything. So take your elemental cannon and shoot the elemental servitor of, again, the right element. But don't just shoot them willy-nilly. You're actually going to have to shoot them and keep holding down that right trigger. Charge up the shot, which is the exact same mechanic that Scorch Cannons have always had. You can charge them, and then once you've charged them long enough, you can actually see the projectiles glow bigger like they've charged to their final level. But basically, hold down the trigger for about 5 seconds and release it, and that's gonna do a massive damaging attack, and that's going to kill the servitor instantly. Once those servitors die, they will drop those SIVA bombs. And what you're going to have to do is the other people who aren't holding on to the cannons are going to have to grab those bombs. You're then going to see these very noticeable glowing red diamonds on the big platform supporting the boss, and throw those bombs at those diamonds, and hitting them is what you need to do. Now, each time you do this, because it's doing that exact same thing, you know, over and over and over again, once you get the mechanics down the first time, you're just doing it again and again. But the first time, you only need to have to throw 2 of those bombs and hit those 2 glowing red diamonds. The second time, there's going to be 3, and the third time, there's going to be 5. Now, as I said earlier, the people who are not holding the Scorch Cannons need to be the ones to pick up those bombs. The reason being is because if you're holding a Scorch Cannon, you will actually get a debuff. and it's called Charge Lockout, and it prevents you from picking up those bombs. However, importantly, you can throw more than one bomb at once, so if someone is dead, get someone else who is still alive, obviously, to pick up the slack, grab two bombs from two different servitors, and hit the two different glowing objectives. The only other thing you need to worry about is, again, on that final round, there's actually going to be two sets of servitors that spawn. So after you kill the first set of servitors and your teammates pick up the bombs and throw them, there's going to be more that spawn, so you're going to have to just shout out where the other ones are. The people with the Scorch Cannons maneuver in the right locations, shoot their servitors, drop more bombs, and then more people pick them up and throw them. And finally, once you've hit all of those objectives with those bombs, you will complete this section and more raid loot will spawn. And now we are on to the final raid boss. Now guys, first things first, the enemies in this area are 380 light. 380. So if you're still rocking 365, you're going to have a lot of trouble. Perhaps go back, try to level up, you know, spam those faction packages, try to get some better loot, because again, that is a pretty high light level and you will get melted very quickly if your light level is just too low. But if you think you're up to snuff, let's get on with how to beat this final encounter. Keep your team split up into groups of two for each side. Now he's going to teleport around the room because he's gained the power of teleportation by putting on some bloody spider legs, but in any event, he is going to teleport to the left, right, and center and shoot at you with these massive SIVA swarm detonations. Now this is going to be a problem. Once he hits the ground with these bullets, it is going to create a big red circle. Being in the circle is going to both slow you and damage you, so make sure you're cognizant of where he is and where he's shooting, because if you get trapped in these SIVA swarms, you will basically instantly die. Now, as you're avoiding taking shots from him, you're also going to have your entire team be really on their game with also taking down the massive amount of shanks that are spawning. Shanks are going to spawn out of the doors in the center, on the right, and on the left, and you really have to take them down. Go out of your way to kill those shanks. If left unchecked, they will massacre your team. In any event, after killing the shanks for a while, you're then going to trigger the next mechanic. You will see that certain guardians become empowered, and you can see from the background gameplay exactly what happens. Your entire screen is going to be kind of glowing bluish white, and you will again be empowered. You can see in the bottom left hand corner, it will say that you're empowered. This will be a big deal later on. Now, once you see guardians become empowered, it's going to trigger the next set of captains to spawn. These captains are going to be exactly the same as last time, where they're going to be different elements. You're going to have to pick up their elemental cannons, and then you're going to have to kill the appropriate servitors. Once you kill those servitors and pick up the bombs, instead of throwing the bombs at the objectives, you throw the bombs at the boss himself. If you hit all three bombs on the boss, you will take down his shields entirely. At this point, it's absolutely essential that the people with empowered are spread out throughout the map. So make sure if you have empowered and people are throwing like the last bomb, make sure you go to the place that doesn't have any empowered people. Because the boss, once his shields are down, he's going to be available to damage. Now this means that he's going to teleport either to the very center of the map, to the right where he teleported before when he was just shooting at you, or the left where he again teleported before when he was just shooting at you, or he may even teleport to the very back center, as you can see here. Wherever he is teleported, the thing you absolutely need to do as quickly as possible is to get someone with empowered to jump on top of his back and hold square on the PlayStation, X on the Xbox to again slam him. As you can see here, once you slam him, that's absolutely fantastic. You're then going to be able to damage that boss for a decent amount of time. Now there's going to be no adds you need to worry about, and the boss basically won't shoot back at all. So you're going to have absolute free range to damage the crap out of this guy. So use snipers if you have them, and Galahorns are great as well, but the thing that does absolutely the most damage is those Scorch Cannons. You only need to use one shot to kill the servitors, and try to do so, because the rest of the shots that you've been saving up can do massive damage to the boss, like 40,000 for a single hit, 60,000 with a tether. By the way, you know, because I mentioned tether, stuff that increases damage output to bosses, like tethers, like weapons of light, have become a lot more useful, but I would still stick to tethers potentially more than weapons of light, because hammers and slam is actually very useful for taking down the captains. In any event, shoot the boss with everything you have, and especially these cannons, and make sure to, just like you were doing with the servitors, charge them up and release them. That's gonna do the massive amount of damage a lot more than if you're just shooting them. However, after damaging him for a bit, he's going to teleport again, and it's going to be random. So, after lowering his shields by throwing the Siva bombs at him, he's going to teleport to a random place, make sure you have an empowered guardian jump on his back and slam, DPS the crap out of him, but also stay spread out, because he's going to teleport to another place, and upon doing so, have another guardian with empowered slam him again, and you're going to be able to DPS him again. He's actually going to teleport one more time, and if you can get that third slam in, you're going to be able to DPS him yet again. So the really important factor in this encounter is getting all three of those slams by those three empowered guardians in, so you have as much time as possible to damage the boss. Very, very importantly, the guardians who have empowered will actually switch every once in a while. So between each round, they will switch whoever they're on. So make sure you're paying attention who actually has the empowered mechanics and who can slam him. Now, if everything goes right and you get three slams and are able to damage him quite a bit, or even if it doesn't and you're only able to get two slams but you can still damage him a decent amount, something else is then going to happen. Once you've hit that three slam limit, or again if you fail to slam, he's going to teleport back to the middle, and it's going to say that Siva density is building up. At which point, head to the back of the map where you spawned, and you can see the large pillars with glowing light on top of them sitting out in the distance. Get your entire team to jump on top of one of these pillars, again, only one of these pillars, and that's going to let you survive the massive wave of Siva that's going to hit your team. Anyone outside of these pillars will die. So again, hop on that pillar, survive that damaging blast, and then hop back off and back into the event. But you'll see that that pillar will actually go down as soon as it's done. And that means you can only use each pillar once. So you have a maximum of 4 rounds, technically 5, I guess, for this encounter. And again, make sure your entire team goes to one pillar. You don't want 2 pillars to go down, and limit the amount of times you can damage him. Now, once you survive that blast by standing on the pillar and you've hopped back inside the arena, that's basically it. You are going to do the exact same thing you did to get to this point again. You're going to kill the Shanks as you avoid his attacks, kill the captains, kill the servitors of the right elements, grab the bombs, throw them at him, lower his shields, slam wherever he teleports, damage him, slam again, damage him, slam again, damage him, and once he's teleported back to the center, head to the back of the map and jump on one of the remaining glowing pillars to survive the blast. Now, once you do enough damage on him, you will be able to trigger the next mechanic. And the next mechanic is the last mechanic, and it's basically the exact same thing that Oryx does, where the boss will go to the middle one last time, and you need to damage him as much as possible. If you're able to do this and you kill him before the next Siva swarm hits, he will die and you will have completed the Wrath of the Machine raid. Now, killing him will actually produce two raid chests. The first one is kind of a special final encounter chest where you get primary weapons. As you can see, I got the raid scout rifle out of this chest. Obviously, you're going to be looking for those. Raid primaries can only spawn in this final encounter. And the other chest is again openable with those SIVA cache keys. Again, remember, at this point, you should have gotten quite a few fragments that you can fashion your own key if you don't have one out of 10 fragments just by opening your inventory and holding square or X. And I do want to say just a little bit of a disclaimer here. Again, this video is going to help basically anyone get through the start to the finish of the raid and know what the hell they're doing. That's why I'm making this video. However, we don't know absolutely everything, and new raid mechanics may emerge. And if so, I'll definitely be making new videos on those. For example, in the final encounter, if you're empowered, you can actually, I guess, slam where the servitor's head and it regenerates your super. That's a mechanic that my team never worried about, and as you saw from the gameplay, we did it and with an extremely smooth run, so I'm not gonna like worry you guys with a mechanic that I'm not even fully aware of yet. But again, the raid will evolve as time goes on. This video is a baseline video showcasing you the base mechanics, a few SIVA clusters, and a few chests to get you started. Anyone who watches this video should be prepared to matchmake in this raid. Now, as I said earlier in the video, guys, making this guide took an absolutely massive amount of work. So if you could just help me out by rating and sharing this video, I would hugely appreciate it. And remember, if you want to see more Destiny content similar to this, don't be afraid to slap that subscribe button. If you want to get in touch with me and keep up to date with the latest channel activity, the best way is to follow me on Twitter. That's linked in the description down below, as is my Twitch channel, which you can also follow. And in fact, I will be doing raid run-throughs with viewers pretty shortly here. So that's definitely worth checking out. Again, I hope you enjoyed this video and found it helpful. And as always, have a good day and good luck in the raid.